A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th Jan, on the front page you have, citizens can skip question on place of birth of parents in NPR form, says Centre. Also it says that no documents are required to be shown by people during NPR and census exercise. So officials of non-BJP ruled states have asked Registrar General of India to remove this column itself on place of birth of mother and father in the proposed NPR National Population Register form. So, and it should be updated simultaneously with the census exercise in April to September. So Registrar General of India and Home Ministry have had convened a day-long conference to discuss about this, and they decided that citizens can skip the questions on place of birth of parents in NPR form. Also, no document will be required. Even question on this place of birth is not mandatory, it is voluntary. So this has been stated. And this is Nirbhaya killers to hang on Feb 1. President also rejected their mercy petition. So now they are going to be hanged. Then below you have, last NDFB faction in Assam calls truce. So this is the last faction of National Democratic Front of Bodoland, which has called truce with the government. So central government and Assam governments as such, and also NDFB's one faction, NDFBS, have signed a tripartite agreement in Delhi for cessation of operations. Means they would not fight against the government and government would not take action against them. So the other one also, NDFB faction has signed a truce. And now this is the third faction, which has also decided to sign a truce with the government. But two of its top guns, that is two of its main leaders, are have fled, so they are not there. Then this is Jammu and Kashmir Panchayat by-polls likely in February-March. So by-elections for 12,776 panchayat seats in Jammu and Kashmir will be held in four phases in February and March. So this is by-election, means seats that have become vacant after the elections. So 12,776 seats are the ones, because elections were held, panchayat elections were held in Jammu and Kashmir in 2018. But these 27,281 sarpanches were elected also, but they could not be filled. And the by-elections could be fought only on party lines, could be fought on party lines also. So security now is an issue. So that is why they said that by-elections would be held now. Because several sarpanches, it is said, elected from South Kashmir are still living in hotels and government accommodation because of threat to their lives. It said as many as 36 union ministers will visit the Kashmir Valley too. So after European parliamentarians visit, foreign diplomats in Delhi visiting, now there are union ministers who are going to visit Jammu and Kashmir. So this is an outreach initiative, it is said. You know, coming back in touch with the people here. Then below you have two bull owners spectator gored to death in Tamil Nadu. So there are 39 people who have been injured in Alanganallur Jallikattu. So this is the bull taming festival of Tamil Nadu, which is held during the time of Pongal, during December Jan period. So 100 have been injured here in Tiruchi, Karur and Pudukottai districts of Tamil Nadu. On page 4, you have local bodies to pay compensation for failure to treat waste, says NGT. So, National Green Tribunal has warned the local bodies that they will be liable to pay a compensation of 10 lakh per month for a population of about 10 lakh if there was continued failure to treat generated waste. So, this is what a bench headed by NGT Chief Justice Adarsh Kumar Goyal has said. He also directed that the environment monitoring cell has to be set in the office of chief secretaries of all states and union territories. On page 8, you have Supreme Court disposes of wife's plea for fair probe into Kalburgi case. So, this is regarding the killing of late activist Kannada writer M.M. Kalburgi. So fair probe into his murder in 2015 is being sought by his wife. So The Supreme Court bench closed the petition after it was apprised of the fact that charge sheet has been filed in the case. So even these assassinations, these deaths, which have murders, which have taken place in Karnataka, even in Maharashtra, of activists are all linked, and they are linked to a right-wing group. So even Gauri Lankesh, the journalist, was killed. So same special investigation team is investigating into these cases. Then there was Narendra Dabolkar, Govind Pansare. So all these cases are linked. Then below you have Supreme Court refuses to intervene in Malankara Row. So this is regarding churches in Malankara controlled by the Orthodox faction. These are churches in Kerala. So here there is a dispute between two factions, the Orthodox factions and the Jacobites. So there is a dispute regarding ritual burning, ritual burials, which Jacobites have in the cemeteries of Malankara churches, but the churches are controlled by the Orthodox faction. So the dispute which has arisen here, the Supreme Court has refused to intervene in that matter. We had seen the Supreme Court order coming, but it said its role is restricted to maintaining peace and law and order. So it will not adjudicate on this dispute as such, but to have peace, law and order, it will give its orders. So it was actually the Orthodox faction which has filed a contempt petition against Kerala government for promulgating an ordinance. So this ordinance provides Christians the right to bury their loved ones in the cemetery where their ancestors are buried. So that is the cause of the entire dispute. So this is Kerala Christian Cemeteries Right of Burial of Corpse Ordinance of 2020. On page 9 you have GSAT 30 gives India communication boost. So this is 3,357 kg satellite which has been launched from Kourou, and Kourou is in French Guiana in South America. So this satellite has been launched from abroad, Indian satellite launched abroad. So you should know about this too. So it's a heavy satellite. So heavy satellites are launched from abroad. So the GSAT 30 will replace the aging INSAT 4A. As such, which is already in orbit. This INSAT 4A was launched in 2005, and now this is the first mission of the year for ISRO, and the satellite has been launched. It has 12 normal C band and 12 Ku band transponders. So you can see ISRO opted for a foreign launch as GSAT 30 is much heavier than the 2000 kg lifting capacity of its geostationary launch vehicle GSLV Mk2. So, the GSLV Mk3 can lift up to 4000 kg, but then there are two or three upcoming launches which are required, the first human space flight which is required. So, it is said that ISRO did not opt for this launch by GSLV Mk3 presently. Save it for that, the other launches. Then below you have merger plan of Rajya Sabha TV and Lok Sabha TV in final stages. So what is being considered by a 6-member committee set by the government is merger of the two televisions. So basically the two televisions show proceedings in each house, and Lok Sabha TV shows Lok Sabha proceedings, even live debates are shown, even on Rajya Sabha TV is related to Rajya Sabha. So if the two are merged and it becomes a single channel, then live transmission of both is not possible. So that is why it is considering how the merger would take place, whether it would be two channels merging into one, or whether it would be the two channels remaining but integrated management with a common pool of technical and human resources. You should know Lok Sabha TV, it was launched in 2006, and later even Rajya Sabha TV was launched. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Fighting Radicalization. So this is yesterday's front page news, in which Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat has said that de-radicalization of Kashmir's Islamist youth is essential. And so if there is radicalization, of course de-radicalization is important, but this editorial says it should not be how General Bipin Rawat speaks of it. He spoke of segregation camps. So such camps we have heard of in China. And now he's talking about girls and boys as young as 10 and 12, they are radicalized and they should be isolated from radicalization in a gradual way, taken out separately to some de-radicalization camp. So such are the suggestions being given, which are being spoken out against in this editorial. And here you have quiet for now. So this is regarding trade deal between US and China. So this allows President Trump to claim some success, because again, this is his idea of having, it's a tactic of putting maximum pressure tactic to get what it wants. So, but it has affected the globe, because this trade war has affected nations globally between US and China. It has not been restricted to these two countries. So the phase one trade deal of US president has been signed between US and China, and a temporary truce has been there. So this allows Trump to claim some success. Then the lead article is a cry against hollow public life. So this talks about how students are protesting on their own as a generation led down by the institutional and political order. And below you have, one government proposes, the next government disposes. So this article talks of how newly elected regimes have the right to review potentially unjust contracts and projects, but only with good reasons. So we have seen many such cases, like the Polavaram project, then the Amravati new capital case, in which, you know, deals have been by previous government have been cancelled. Even in Maharashtra, we have seen many such initiatives taken that have been cancelled. So it talks about this trend. Then on the op-ed page on Saturdays, you have this ground zero coverage, which is detailed coverage on a particular issue. So this is regarding how government hospitals are poorly equipped and understaffed, and the failure of the primary healthcare systems too has led to deaths of children. So in Kota also, there was this news of more than 100 children dying in the last 40 days. So this is a coverage on this issue now in Kota. Then on page 12, you have Jammu and Kashmir to be no social media zone for broadband users. So Ministry of Home Affairs has kicked off a humongous exercise to consolidate its technical muscle to stop access to all platforms of the social media in Kashmir. So it has been asked by the government to not have complete internet ban. So government said that they need to have complete internet ban because they cannot selectively ban it. So now Ministry of Home Affairs is initiating this technical capabilities are being used to stop access to all platforms of social media in Kashmir. Internet providers have also been told to prevent access to all platforms. On page 13, you have 2020 will be an important year for Indo-US relations. So US President Donald Trump is likely to visit India too. So venue and date is being finalized, and focus will be on Indo-US engagements. The 2+2 dialogue takes place, in which two important ministers from India side, that is defense and foreign ministers, meet their US counterparts. The last meeting took place in December 2019. So this is important. So decisions taken here will be taken forward as such, is what has been stated. Then below you have UK plans government to government framework for future defense deals with India. So UK government is working on a government to government framework, means we generally have bidding process and then procurements take place, but now we are seeing even with US government it is foreign military sales route which is used, and here now UK is also saying we would have government to government deals in defense deals. So it says we will do this because of India's preference for such arrangements. On international page, you have Pakistan Islamists get 55 years in jail for protests. So there were protests, violent rallies which took place in 2018 in Pakistan, and those who participated in them have got 55 years in jail. So there are 86 members of a radical Islamist party which have been sentenced here. So the protests had taken place over the acquittal of Christian woman in a blasphemy case. Means she had spoken up on religion which was not to the liking of the Islamists. So it's called blasphemy, and they had protested, and these were violent rallies, and now the 86 members have been sentenced to 55 years in jail. And below you have phone scandal rocks Sri Lanka's opposition party. So this is regarding leaked conversations between the ruling party and between the of the opposition party. So this is UNP. So the opposition party here, and they are talking about these phone conversations, are talking about details on court cases against several high profile figures. So this has been leaked. So several judges, police officers and politicians are under the spotlight, and has delivered a huge blow to the main opposition party in Sri Lanka now. And this is China's birth rate hits lowest level since 1949. So its birth rate has dropped in 2019 to its lowest level since the communist country was founded in 1949. So the concerns are there that an aging society and shrinking workforce will pile pressure on a slowing economy now. So one child policy as such was relaxed in 2016 to allow people to have two children, but the change has not resulted in an increase in pregnancies. On business page you have center sets higher GST mop-up target. So now with less than 3 months to go before the current financial year ends, enforcement actions have multiplied and pressure has mounted on revenue officers to augment GST collections in the remaining period of the financial year. And it has tightened the nose around evaders. Revenue secretary is monitoring collections. And here you have Amazon to create 1 million new jobs in India by 2025. So this is Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, and it is, he's the CEO of Amazon too. So he says that jobs, 1 million new jobs will be created in India. And it is said technical, retail, logistics, manufacturing, content are the areas in which jobs will be created and they'll benefit. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.